Hi folks, this is Checkpoint Quiz 11.2. In number one, we're asked to solve the following triangles. We're given information about the triangles. So what's it mean to solve a triangle? Well, we're given three pieces of information about the triangle, and then we're asked to determine the other three pieces. Now, it doesn't matter how we arrange these things in the triangle, except for one point. We're operating under the convention that alpha A, beta B, and gamma C are the angle side opposite pair. Okay, so when I go ahead to just sketch out this triangle, I'm going to call that alpha, beta, and gamma. So I'm going to just label the angles counterclockwise there. And the length of the side opposite the angle alpha is A. The length of the side opposite angle beta is B, and the length of the side opposite angle gamma I'm going to call C. And one of the tools we have that is going to help us with this example is the law of sines. And the law of sines says that the ratio sine alpha over A equals sine beta over B equals sine gamma over C holds throughout the triangle. Okay? So these ratios are the same. And depending on the context, we can flip all these over as well. And these ratios hold as well. Okay, so this is really the same mathematical equation here, because none of these quantities can be zero in a triangle. Okay, so we're given alpha is 30 degrees, gamma is 45 degrees, and B is 10. So let's try to sketch out the triangle we're given. Oops. So that's 30 degrees, that's 45 degrees, and B is 10. Okay? All right, so first thing I can go after pretty quick is beta. All right, we're given an angle, an included side, and another angle. So from geometry, this is the angle side angle case. We know that determines one and only one triangle. And so in order to use the law of sines, I need to know the ratio of an angle side opposite pair. I don't have C or A, so our hope rests in finding B. Since I have two angles in the triangle, I can quickly get the third, because I know that the sum of the measures of the angles in any triangle always adds up to 180 degrees. So that means that beta I can find by taking 180 minus alpha minus beta, which is 180 minus 30 minus 45 degrees. And so that's going to be 150 degrees minus 45 degrees. That's 105 degrees. So that's what beta is. Beta is 105 degrees. Now I've got an angle side opposite pair, I can go off and use law of sines. So what's left to find is the length of the side opposite alpha, A, and the length of the side opposite gamma, C. Since we're solving for the lengths of the sides of the triangle, it's going to be more direct if we use this version of the law of sines. And so we'll go off and do that. So if we go after A, I know A over sine of alpha is B over sine of beta. So A over the sine of 30 degrees is B, which is 10. Over the sine of 105 degrees. So I can quickly get A to be 10 sine of 30 degrees over sine 105 degrees. All right, and we'll come back and simplify this in a minute. Similarly, to go after C then, C over sine of gamma is B over sine of beta. So C over the sine of 45 degrees is 10 over the sine of 105 degrees. So that gives us C equals 10 sine 45 degrees. Divided by the sine of 105 degrees. All right, so those are the exact answers for A, C, and beta. Now let's see if we can simplify those. Okay, let's simplify our answers. Beta is 105 degrees. A is 10 sine 30 over sine 105. B is 10 sine 45 over sine 105. Now, sine 105 we can actually figure out exactly, because it's the sum of this of 105 is the sum of the of two angles we know. So this is sine of 60 degrees, cosine of 45 degrees, plus cosine of 60 degrees times sine of 45 degrees. Simplify that. Square root 3 over 2 times square root 2 over 2 plus 1 half square root 2 over 2. So I get square root of 6 plus the square root of 2 over 4. Okay? And I know the sine of 30 and the sine of 45. So here we go. I've got 10 sine of 30, which is 1 half, divided by this. Which is 5 times, or 5 over 1 rather, that's the numerator, times the reciprocal of this. So it's 20 over radical 2 plus radical 6. All right, now I could rationalize the denominator if I want, or I could factor out a radical 2. There's actually a couple different things I could do here at this point. But that's more of a simplified answer than what I had here. And I can put this then in the calculator, and I will get approximately 5.18. Or I could just go to my calculator in the green mode and plug that in. Okay. Over here, I get 10 times radical 2 over 2 divided by this, which is going to give me 5 radical 2 over 1 times this. Gives me 20 radical 2 over radical 2 plus radical 6. And I can actually factor out a radical 2 from everything. You get 20 over 1 plus radical 3. If you work that out, that ends up being roughly 7.32. So it depends on what your instructor wants to do. If they want you to simplify it at least to here and then use a calculator, or that could be considered the exact answer, and then just put your calculator in the green mode to get that answer directly. It's up to your instructor, okay? But that'll do it then for 1A.